Okay, in last classes we discussed about some types of plant tissues. Majorly we can differentiate plant tissues into four types. What are they? First one is meristematic tissues. Next one, dermal tissue. Next, ground tissues. Next, vascular tissues. These are four types of tissues. Observe carefully. In last classes, you studied about the meristematic tissues. Next, some characteristic features are the dermal tissue. Understanding some of the characteristic features. Okay. Next, here there are some other characteristic features of dermal tissue. Okay. Last class we discussed some points and some characteristic features of dermal tissue. Means location of the dermal tissue, types of the dermal tissue, and some activities to observe the dermal tissues. Like this, some topics, some points of dermal tissue were completed in last class. Understanding? Now let us observe some other characteristic features of the dermal tissue. Okay, here. When we observe the root system, listen carefully here. When we observe the root system, here we can observe hair-like structures. We can observe hair-like structures developed from the dermal tissue, means epidermis. Means epidermis. Actually, epidermis is the outermost layer of tissue of the root system or root. Okay, epidermis. From this epidermis, hair-like structures are developed. These hair-like structures are called actually root hairs. Listen carefully. They are root hairs. What are the functions of root hairs? Root hairs are present in root system. Okay. What are the main functions of the root hairs? What are the main functions? No. Already we discussed in lower classes about root hairs. For example, Here, these are dermal tissue cells. This is the dermal tissue epidermis actually here. In this condition here, epidermis. This is the root hair. Observe carefully. Next cell. Here, these are the root hairs. Sir, root hairs, this is epidermis. Observe carefully. Okay, what is the main function of root hairs? Function of the root hair is absorption of water, absorption of water from soil. This is the main function of the root hairs. Here, along with water, some essential nutrients are elements. Okay, essential nutrients are essential elements. Understanding? Essential elements. Nutrients are essential elements. They are also absorbed by root hairs. They are also absorbed by root hairs. How can they absorb? How can they absorb actually? How can means? Here we saw the soil particles. In soil, plenty of water is present, means water concentration is very high. Water concentration is very high in soil. But instead of the root hedge, water concentration is low. Water concentration is low. Understanding? Listen carefully. Now what happened? Osmosis process takes place here. Which process? Osmosis process takes place. What is osmosis? Osmosis means movement of water or water molecules from high water concentrated area or from its higher concentration to its lower. Area through plasma membrane. Understanding? Process of movement of water from its higher concentrated area or its higher concentration to its lower concentrated area through plasma membrane. It is called osmosis process. Understanding? Due to osmosis process, water from high water concentrated area to low water concentrated area like this moves. Water moves from high water concentrated area to low water concentrated area. In this way, water is absorbed by the root heads. These root heads are originated from the dermal tissue cells. Are understanding? Observe carefully. Next, some dermal cells some dermal tissue cells secrete type of secretions. They are usually gums. What? gums. What is the use of gums? What is the use of gums? Can you say what is the use? Yes. Here they play a very important role during the injury. For example, a plant gets injured. For example, injuries. Then what happens? Dermal tissue secretes. Dermal tissue cells secrete one type of sticky secretions. These are called gums. They cover the. They cover the injuries. Or they, for example, here there is a wound. Then these gums are released from the dermal tissue and they are accumulated on the wound and they prevent the entry of microorganisms. Entry of microorganisms. Disease causing organisms. Disease causing organisms. This is the main important function. And they help in healing of wounds or healing of the injuries. This is the main function of the gums. Actually, these are secondary byproducts. Secondary byproducts. Are secondary metabolites. Secondary metabolites. Understanding. Observe it. Next, during the secondary growth stems, during the secondary growth in stems, what happened? Actually, cork kilium is developed. Actually, cork kilium. Okay, it forms secondary phloem. Next, here is secondary phloem towards the inner side. Next, cork tissue towards the outer side. Understanding? Cork tissue towards the outer side. Here and there you can observe parenchymal cells. Okay, and here cork cambium, it forms the bark. It forms bark. understanding. Isn't it clear? Verb means total corp cambium. Cambium. Next, secondary phloem, secondary cortex, cambium develop the secondary cortex for the nasals. Okay, next, towards the outer side, cork tissue. Understanding? What? Cork tissue. These three are collectively called as bulb. This is actually called as bulb. Bulb is developed on the dermal tissue during the secondary growth on dermal tissue. On dermal tissue. Second, on dermal tissue, bark is developed. Bark is impervious to gases. Bark is impervious to gases. It cannot allow the gases into the stem. So how can gases enter into the stem? How can we? Stems have some pore-like structures. They are called actually lenticels. Through these lenticel structures, gases are entered into the stem. Understanding? Observe carefully. Next, third type of tissues, brown tissues. What? Brown tissues. Okay, what are brown tissues? Actually, bulk of the plants, mass region of the plants is made up of brown tissue. Isn't it clear? Maximum all parts of plants are made up of the ground tissue. Majority of the region of plants are made up of ground tissues. Abundant amount of tissue present in plants is ground tissue. Understanding? It is present as carpets. Mainly it is present as cortex in root stem. Next up, mesophyll tissue. In leaf. Understanding? Next to medulla are thick in root stem. Listen carefully. Life is different in some as hypodermis, okay, for example, dicotyl, like this. It is present in different forms. Like this, in some plants as cortex, in some plants as some parts as mesophyll, medullary phase, hypodermis. Like this, these are the different parts of the ground tissues. Observe. Observe carefully. Ground tissue. Majority of the parts of plants, most of the made up of this ground tissue. What? Ground tissue. Okay. Grab the ones. Here, ground tissues are also called as simple tissues. Ground tissues are also called as simple tissues. What are simple tissues? Simple tissues means all cells present in tissue or similar. All cells are similar. And all cells are originated from same ancestor. Okay, all cells originated from the same cell means origin is same. Structure and shape is also similar. Function is also similar. And similar and function is also similar or same. All cells are only one type of cells. All cells are only one type of cells. What are simple tissues means? Tissues which are made up of only one type of similar cells. Only one type of similar cells. They are called simple tissues. Observe carefully. Tissues which are made up of only one type of cells are called simple tissues. Are called simple tissues. Okay. What are they? Let us study different types of ground tissues or simple tissues. Observe there are three types of ground tissues. First one, parenchyma. Second one, colenchyma. Third one, parenchyma. These are three types of ground tissues. Let us study first of all parenchyma. Parenchyma tissue, type of simple tissue. All cells are arranged loosely loosely. There are intercellular spaces, large intercellular spaces, are intercellular spaces all cells are similar in structure and functions. Observe carefully. Next, thin cell walls are present. Thin cell walls are so important characteristic features of the parenchyma tissue. Important characteristic features of parenchyma. Okay, observe once. Based on their functions, there are again different types. Parenchyma cells are again different types. Okay, for example, chlorenchyma. Aerenchyma. Next, storage tissue. Water storage and food storage. Okay. What is chlorenchyma? What is chlorenchyma tissue? Chlorenchyma means tissue, parenchyma tissue, which has chloroplast, within it, and which can perform the photosynthesis process, is called chlorenchyma. Parenchyma tissue which has chloroplast. And which can perform photosynthesis process. This type of parenchyma is called chlorenchyma. Understanding? Observe here. What is the location of this chlorenchyma? Actually, chlorenchyma is present lives as mesophyll. Mesophyll tissue. Lives as mesophyll tissue in stem. In stem as general cortex. In stem as general cortex. Understand? Observe carefully. Many chlorenchyma is present in these two. Next again, God cells. Means that God cells actually, understanding, chlorenchyma is present in leaves and stem. Okay, observe carefully. What is the function of chlorenchyma? Photosynthesis. What? Photosynthesis is the main function of the chlorenchyma. Okay. Next, second one, parenchyma. Chlorenchyma tissue is present as, for example, intercellular spaces are present here also. Here, chloroplasts, number of chloroplasts are present in chlorenchyma cells. Observe carefully, this here chlorenchyma tissue. Here, these are chloroplasts. These are actually chloroplasts. Now, second one is parenchyma. Here, parenchyma means parenchyma tissue which has large air cavities in it. Listen carefully here. Parenchyma which has large air cavities are large air spaces. Understanding large air cavities within it. Within it. This type of parenchyma is called parenchyma. Actually, parenchyma tissue is present only in aquatic plants. Only aquatic plants. Why only aquatic plants have parenchyma tissue? Parenchyma tissue helps the aquatic plants to float on the water surface or to live in mid regions of the water or water resource. Understanding? Actually, it creates the buoyancy capacity. What? Buoyancy capacity to the aquatic plants. Due to presence of the parenchyma tissue, aquatic plants can float. Understanding? Actually, due to presence of water and other mass of the biomolecules or mass of the biochemical compounds in plants, they cannot float on the water. But some aquatic plants, they prefer to live on surface of the water or at mid regions of the water. Understanding? In such plants create this type of parenchyma tissue. Understanding? Parenchyma tissue has large eight cavities with eight in it. With eight. Understanding? Due to presence of eight inside of the body of the plants or inside of eight cavities of the parenchyma tissue, plants can float on the water. Understanding? Okay, observe with me in short example. Here this is A actual. This is eight cavities. Observe carefully once. Due to presence of this type of eight cavities, plants can float on the water. This is very important characteristic feature of aquatic plants. It creates the buoyancy capacity to aquatic plants. Buoyancy capacity. Okay, floating capacity. Understanding? Actually, example for this, Pistia, Nymphia nilambo, Nymphia, this type of plants. Okay, next part one. Storage tissue means parenchyma tissue which can store the food material or water is called storage tissue. Okay, isn't it clear? Parenchyma. Which can store food material and food material or water. Food material or water is called storage tissue. Actually, for example, carrot. Know very well that carrot. Next, some other ones, radish, any other ones. For example, radish, you know very well that. Carrot. Next, potato. Okay, here in these type of plants, parenchyma tissue stores food material. Stores food material. In some plants, for example, aloe vera. Opuntia means cactus. Means here. Cactus. In this type of plants, parenchyma tissue stores water. Okay, means in all the different types of tissues, in all the different types of storage plants or storage tissues, parenchyma tissue is present. For example, observe radish, carrot, potato. Okay, onion. Okay, water storage tissue is present onion. Okay, next sweet potato, beetroot. All are the important plants. They contain the parenchyma tissue, which can store the food material. Means storage tissue is present. Understanding? Observe carefully. This is about three types of parenchyma. Okay, next class we will discuss about the next type of the ground tissue, that is polenchyma. Okay.